Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. In the previous lecture, we have got to know about what are the chemical properties of or that could be exhibited by the alkyl halides. So in that case, we have also discussed about various reaction of alkyl halide with that of different kind of chemicals. So as I mentioned earlier also that I have to elaborate that kind of reaction in the previous lecture. So this is the lecture that I'm going to talk about. So we are going to talk about each of the chemical property of the alkyl halide. So I'm talking about the first one, that is, what is the reaction of the alkyl halide with that of the moist H2O, as well as what is the reaction of alkyl halide with that of, that is, aqueous KOH. So now let us talk about that. So here are the chemical properties that I am going to talk about. That is, what is the reaction of the alkyl halide with that of aqueous KOH solution. So this is the first thing that I am going to talk about. So let us understand what is the general reaction behind this and what is the product that we could get and how the product that we could get with the examples that we could talk about. So now let us start with the first one, that is, what is the reaction of the alkyl halide with that of aqueous KOH. So the reaction of the alkyl halide with that of the aqueous KOH can be given by the general reaction, and that is what I am going to talk about. That is, suppose if RX, which is basically the general formula for the alkyl halide, if that has been reacted with that of the aqueous KOH solution, so therefore I am mentioning over here as aqueous, The reason behind that is, I am mentioning aqueous here is because there is different kind of reaction that could be exhibited by the alkyl halide with that of aqueous KOH as well as the alcoholic KOH. So basically, this is a kind of reaction that will give you a substitution reaction, and while talking about when we use alcoholic KOH, so that would be giving us the elimination reaction. So specifically, we are going to talk about what is the reaction of the alkyl halide with that of aqueous KOH solution. So it is very easy to understand that it is a kind of substitution reaction where we have to take the alkyl halide along with that of potassium hydroxide and we have to boil it. So this kind of reaction would take place in such a way that the potassium atom along with that of this halogen atom, that is this X atom, that would be removed as a byproduct in the form of, that is, KX. Well, the remaining part that would be left out is this alkyl group, that is R, and this OH group, that is an alcoholic or hydroxyl group. So this R along with this of OH, basically it is known as alcohol. So this is a general reaction, and in this case we could easily say that whenever an alkyl halide has been treated with aqueous potassium hydroxide and if we boil it, then the product that we could get is an alcohol and basically KX as a byproduct. So this was a general reaction, and let me talk about the example. So let us talk about the example first. So talking about the example, let me consider that is suppose C2H5Br. Obviously it is known as ethyl bromide, or according to the IUPAC, we are going to prefer IUPAC name. So therefore the IUPAC name for this molecular formula, it would be given as one bromo ethane. So whenever one bromo ethane is being treated with aqueous KOH solution, so therefore if I am treating it with aqueous KOH solution or aqueous potassium hydroxide, then obviously that is this potassium along with that of this bromine atom, that would be removed in the form of KBr. So the only thing that would be left out is, that is, C2H5 along with that of this OH group. So therefore it will make us to obtain, that is, ethanol. So this is what we have, and this is the general reaction that I was talking about, and it should be mentioned that this kind of reaction that we are talking about is basically a type of reaction which is basically known as substitution reaction, because here the substitution reaction takes place where this Br is been replaced by the OH, or this Br is been substituted by the OH group of the KOH, and this is what we have. So this is a very simple reaction that we have talked about, and not only that is we can use KOH solution, but we can also use aqueous NOH solution, or basically we could call it as sodium hydroxide. So even though if you use sodium hydroxide, because it is a base, so even though if you use that, then the product would be the same. Only the difference will be the byproduct will be the different, but meanwhile talking about the main product, that would be the same. So this was one of the example that I was talking about, and that's it. This was the first chemical property that I have talked in our previous lecture, that is during the chemical properties of the alkyl halide. And so now let us talk about what is the reaction of alkyl halide with that of moist silver oxide. So here I am going to talk about what is the reaction of alkyl halide with that of moist silver oxide. So let me give you the general reaction of this first. So it could be represented in this way, that is whenever an alkyl halide, that is RX, is treated with, that is moist Ag2O. Or moist silver oxide. So whenever the moist silver oxide, actually it will produce, that is AgOH, that is silver hydroxide. So whenever a silver hydroxide is been produced because of the moist Ag2O, so therefore this AgOH is known as silver hydroxide. That would be responsible to give the substitution reaction in such a manner that this X along with this Ag, so therefore this will be moved in the form of, that is AgX, and this is also a kind of substitution reaction that takes place over here, where we could find that this Ag along with this halogen atom, that would be moved as a byproduct, and we could find that this AgX is being produced as a byproduct, and the only thing that would be left out is basically this R, that is the alkyl group, along with that of this OH group. So therefore it would get, that is to convert it into an alcohol. So therefore this is an alcohol that we have got over here. So this is the general reaction, and the most important thing is we have to consider the general reaction as the most preferred one, because once we get to know about the general reaction, then any question, suppose if it comes during the conversion of suppose a reactant into somewhere a product, if we have to convert, so because of the general reaction, if you know, we can easily produce that kind of product, or we can easily solve that kind of question if it comes in our exam. So this is what I was talking about, and now let us give me an example related to this one. So it is very easy to now to understand that what would be the reaction that could occur. Suppose if we have the reactant such as an alkyl halide, suppose if I am talking about in this way, that is so therefore this is an alkyl bromide, and basically when I am talking about specifically about the IUPAC name, then this would be called as two bromopropane. And whenever the 2-bromopropane is being treated with, that is moist silver oxide, and that silver moist silver oxide, it will produce, that is silver hydroxide, and that silver hydroxide basically it is represented like AgOH. And now here we have to, that is mentioned, that is moist Ag2O, that is the most necessary part over here. And the only thing now that we could produce over here is, because again a substitution reaction that would take place over here, and I could find that this Ag along with that of this Br or this bromine atom, that would be removed in the form of, that is AgBr as a byproduct, and the only thing that would be left out is basically the isopropyl group along with that of this OH. Basically we could get CH3 over here, I have written over here, and this is basically OH. The name of this one is very much easy to understand, that is the name of this one would be propane 2, that is propanol, propane 2 also. This is what we have got over here, and that's the general reaction related to this one. So this is the reaction that I was talking about, and so in this lecture we have got to know about how the alkyl hair can be converted to alcohol by using different reagents, like that is KOH solution, that is aqueous potassium hydroxide, along with that of that is aqueous sodium hydroxide, and we have also discussed about what is the reaction with that of the silver oxide, moist silver oxide. Obviously, we could say that is what is the reaction of alkyl hair with that of that is silver hydroxide. So ultimately, the product that we could get or we have got is basically an alcohol. So this is the thing that I was talking about, and this all has been covered in a single lecture only. So there was no separate lecture that I've mentioned over here, and because of the general reaction also we have got over that how can we make such kind of alcohols using alkyl halide. And now let us solve some kind of examples so that we could be able to understand that what the product would be formed, and how the reaction could be, that is it should be represented when a particular question is being given to us. So what are the questions? Let me talk about that one. So related to what we have understood in this lecture, there's a question, that is how can you convert an alkyl halide to 2-methyl propane to all? So therefore, the thing that we could do is we can get an alkyl halide that is very much resembling to that of the alkyl group that has been present in the product. So the product that we could get is basically 2-methyl propane to all. So here is a question, that is how can you convert an alkyl halide to 2-methyl propane to all? So here the product that we know is basically an alcohol, and we have to obtain this from an alkyl halide. So this alcohol that we have, that can be obtained from an alkyl halide, but that alkyl halide should have a alkyl group that should be related to this product. And what is that? Let me talk about that. But we know different methods from which we could obtain this 2-methyl propane 2-ol from an alkyl halide by using different reagents, like that of like moist silver hydroxide, or we could also use that as aqueous KOH solution. So suppose let me give this reaction with the help of that is aqueous KOH solution. So the thing that we have to obtain over here is we have to obtain that is 2-methyl propane 2-ol. So therefore that could be written as in the form of the IUPAC structure, that could be given as that is CH3, here it is, that is it is a propane, while on the second position there is a methyl group, and on the second position of that is during the IUPAC naming or IUPAC numbering, so here it is, that is OH group. So this alcohol can be obtained if the reactant will consist of this alkyl group. And this alkyl group is what we will get over here, that is a tertiary butyl group, that is what we have over here. So therefore we have to take that only, that is CH3, and here also there will be CH3, and this is a tertiary butyl group. And what we have to consider is we have to obtain this product from an alkyl halide. So therefore here we could take any of the halides like this one, like chlorine. And if you have to obtain this one, suppose if I'm reacting it with that of that is a KOH solution, that is aqueous KOH solution. So the thing is, this potassium along with that of this Cl atom, that would be removed in the form of that is KCl. And this is the product that we have. So this is how we have got, but it is not necessary that we have to use only KOH. We can use any of the reagent that we have discussed in the lecture, and talking about the name of this one. So therefore this could be given as the name, because this is a chlorine group that has been present over here, and according to the IUPAC name, the Cl should be in the first. So therefore we could also name this as that is 2-chloro-2-methyl, that is propane. Well, this is the product that we have, that is 2-methyl propane 2-ol, and the only thing that we have to do here is this is the thing that we have obtained over here. So this is the question, then this kind of question can be it could come in the exam, and this is how we can solve it. And now let us move on to the next question that we have, that is, so this is the question that we have, and it says that what is the action of moist Ag2O on that is N-propyl bromide. So here the name that has been given, it has been given as a common name, so even we have to understand what would be the structure of the common name. So what we have to do is we have to make the action, or we have to react, that is moist Ag2 along with that of this N propyl bromide. So it is very much easy to understand. That is, suppose to draw the structure of N propyl bromide, it is very easy. That is CH3, CH2, CH2, and here it is bromine, and this is nothing but N propyl bromide. And according to the IPCC name, the name of this one would be, that is 1-bromo propane. And now we have to, that is, treat it with, that is, moist silver oxide, that is Ag2O. But this silver oxide will produce, that is, AgOH. And now this Ag, that is this silver atom along with that of this bromine atom, that would be removed in the form of, that is, AgBr as a salt. And the rest of the thing that we have here over here is basically this propyl group and this that is OH. So therefore the name of this one would be CH3, CH2, CH2, and here it is OH. And the name is basically N-propyl alcohol, or we could also call it as that is propanol. So that's it. This is what we have got to know about, that is how can we convert an alkyl halide to an alcohol. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.